What's up guys, Rogue9 here. I've already covered Hibana's ex-Kairos gadget, now it's time for Echo's drone Yokai. Off we go! The brand new Defender Echo has a gadget named Yokai, which is a hovering drone that releases disorienting sonic bursts. Yokai also transmits a video feed to the operator. Who would have thought? And the bonus nugget of knowledge here is that Yokai are a class of supernatural monsters, spirits, and demons in Japanese folklore. And look at that, you've already learned something. Drones have been a part of Rainbow Six Siege since the very beginning, but this is the first time that a Defender gets a drone. When deployed, this flying drone starts out in a low hover state. Movement is quite similar to Twitch's drone, since you do not have the ability to jump over obstacles like standard drones do. Unlike the offensive drones in the game, you also lack the ability to mark opponents. So if you're using this drone as an observation tool, it is vital that you have voice communication with your team. When in this movement state, Yokai is quite vulnerable since it can be easily spotted, it cannot use the standard jump ability to try to avoid being shot at, and it also has no way of defending itself. This drone has a second mode though. Since it is a hover drone, it has a capability of jumping quite high, straight upwards, and once you hit the ceiling, the drone will attach there, and this is where the fun really starts. Once attached to the ceiling, the drone becomes immobile, but you can still move the camera around. A real cool feature of the drone when you enter into this sticky mode is that after 2 seconds, it becomes kind of cloaked, kind of see-through. Yeah, I guess cloaked is what you could call it. And while it's not completely invisible, depending on where you attach it, it can become very hard to spot. As the operator of the drone, you can tell when you're entering cloaking mode by this sort of shard-like effect in your view. And that will simply be down to the cloaking device interacting with the camera in some way that makes sense, I guess. And it is only after you enter this sticky mode that you can actually use the drone's weapon. The device has 3 charges of a sonic blast that can severely disorient enemy players as well as friendly players, so be careful what you aim at. When you're hit by this sonic blast, you get this kind of blurry, slightly shaky, speckled effect over your view. I compared being hit once with being hit 3 times in a row by the blast in order to find out if there is a cumulative effect of being hit by these shocks. The answer is no, there is not. Whether you're hit once or 3 times quickly in a row, the disorienting effect is exactly the same and it will last 10 seconds from the last time you were hit. Other players will be able to tell that you're disoriented because your character will take one hand off of their weapon and kind of rub the side of their head. And I suppose that's fair enough given that you've just been hit by a massive concussive blast. Once you've been hit by one of these blasts, there is a way that you can make the effect actually worse for yourself, and that's by moving. The faster you move, the worse it actually gets for you. If you start running after you've been hit by the blast, you'll actually get this tunnel vision effect, and your view will be extremely restricted. In addition to that, you'll also get quite an extreme camera sway, and the effect can last up to 20 seconds instead of just the 10 seconds it will last when you're standing still. So how you react to being hit by Yokai has to depend on your situation. Even though running away will definitely make the effects worse, sometimes you might have to do that to avoid being rushed and killed by a Defender. Finally, as mentioned before, the drone has 3 total charges for its sonic blast, but they do recharge over time. It takes 20 seconds to recharge 1 shot, so a complete refill can take up to 1 minute. So that's the basic operation of the drone. Now let's dive a little bit deeper and take a closer look at some of its limitations. Even though the drone has quite a significant jumping capability, there is a limit to it. As a general rule of thumb, you can say that you can attach to most ceilings, but jumping up through a floor hatch to try to reach the ceiling above is not going to happen. Also, in levels where you have rooms with particularly high ceilings, such as the entrance lobby of the bank, you will also be limited in your ability to attach the drone. In situations like this, the only way you can actually go ahead and attach the drone to the ceiling is by throwing it on top of a cupboard or other object first, and thereby giving yourself a little starting altitude. Another limitation to the drone is that you are not allowed outside at all. If you do leave the building you're defending, you will have 3 seconds to get back inside, otherwise the drone will shut down. If this happens, the only way to regain control of your drone is to actually go outside, pick it up, and bring it back inside with you. Once this is done, full functionality will be restored. The drone's sonic blast is a very useful weapon, but it is only intended for use against humans. There may be situations in which you might be tempted to try to fire the blast at an enemy gadget, such as a claymore, or a wall-breaching device, or a grenade of some type. This will have absolutely no effect, so you might as well save your charge. On the other hand, if you catch someone trying to deploy one of those gadgets, including placing a diffuser, you can actually go ahead and interrupt that action. This interrupt also works on players using their special ability. For instance, you can stop Montagna from using his deployed shield, and hitting a character who's either droning or in a camera feed will also interrupt that action. But here's an interesting thing, if you go straight back into the camera after having been hit, your visual impairment actually goes away. But this is only while you're watching the camera feed. If you disengage from the camera, your vision will be right back where it would be. Keep in mind though that these interruptions only last for an instant and that the other player can simply restart whatever action he was performing straight away. But not every action can be interrupted, like for instance Sledge's hammer swing or throwing grenades or flashbangs. And neither can a reload animation or the animation of picking up a hostage. If you blast the hostage either before or after having been picked up by an attacking player, the hostage will become disoriented and you will lose points for friendly fire. But other than that, there's no effect at all. If you pick up a disoriented hostage, you'll be able to move just as quickly and just as easily as you would normally. Likewise, if you're hit while you're already escorting the hostage, yes, you'll obviously be hit and you'll get the same disorienting effect as you normally would, but again, having the hostage with you makes no difference. And now that we've covered some of the blast's capabilities, here's another drawback. The range of the blast is limited. As the operator of the drone, you do get an indication for this. Up to a distance of 12 meters, your targeting reticle will actually turn red when you aim at the head of an opponent. Likewise, it will turn green if you aim at a friendly unit. And that will certainly give you an indication of whether or not your target is in range, but it is not perfect because your maximum range is actually 13 meters rather than just 12. And finally, another drawback compared to the offensive drones is that the camera feed cannot be shared with teammates. Even though defensive players can all access the camera network, including Valkyrie's Black Eye cameras, none of the other defenders can actually switch to Yokai's camera feed. So like I mentioned earlier, having voice communication with your team is critical. And finally, as IQ would say, if it runs on batteries, I will see it. Which of course means that yes, since Yokai is an electronic device, IQ can find it with her scanner. And if it can be found by a scanner, there's a very good chance that a shot from Twitch's shock drone will destroy it. And yes, that is also the case. So after what seems like a fairly long list of limitations, here's a few of Yokai's strengths. This drone is not affected by any of the defensive gadgets. You can drive straight through electrified barbed wire, and you will not be affected by signal jammers. Likewise, Yokai is also not affected by claymores. You can jump straight through the laser if you wish, you will not trigger them. This also goes for Capcan's laser trip mines. And last but not least, the drone is also EMP resistant. An EMP grenade will disable the drone for a total of 10 seconds, but if the drone is not discovered and destroyed during that time, you can go straight back to using it. So there you have it, quite a comprehensive video on Yokai and all of its capabilities and weaknesses, and even though it took me a couple of extra days to make this video, I definitely hope that it was worth the wait. Is there anything I missed out? Well, you know the drill. Leave a comment below, let me know, and I'll take a look at it. If you're interested in the capabilities and limitations of Hibana's ex-Kairos gadget, feel free to check out part 1 by clicking the link on the right-hand side of the screen now. And with that, guys, nothing remains to be said except I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you in the next episode.